Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I am JT Gooney. In this series, we're going to be bringing you guys the best loadouts that you can use for every single gun in Warzone, starting after the Season 4 update. There were a bunch of nerfs, a bunch of tweaks to all of the guns. We're still trying to figure out what's going to be viable and what's going to be good because the update did just drop a couple of days ago. So make sure you guys stay tuned on the channel to figure out the best loadouts for every single gun. There will be a video every day from here on forward so you guys don't miss out. If you guys do like the video, make sure you hit a thumbs up. Make sure you guys subscribe. And if you really like what you see, go check me out over on Twitch. I stream 4 days a week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. Every Friday we do community customs. So if you guys want to be a part of that, be sure to follow me over on Twitch. Everyone is welcome. Anyone can play. There's really no restrictions to it. So, with all that being said, let's get right on into it.
Plunder. Secure cash by completing contracts, looting, or eliminating targets. Set a drop point for your team, soldier.
That's our drop zone. Get ready.
Enemy soldier incoming. Team is tracking your position. Enemy dropping into the AO. UAV overhead. Enemy dropping into the AO. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies. Enemy UAV overhead. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies.
After the Season 4 update, they did a lot of weapon balancing. This is probably our biggest weapon balancing patch that we've had to date in Call of Duty Warzone. The Grau was buffed, the M13 was buffed, the FFAR was nerfed again, the CR56 was nerfed again. I don't remember if they nerfed the M4A or buffed the M4A1, excuse me, but we are going to go over this loadout anyway. This is a grizzled veteran in the Warzone space. This gun has been around for, you know, as long as the game has been out, this has been one of the top hitters as far as people using it in their loadout. It's the M4A1 for Modern Warfare, and a lot of this is going to be stuff you've already heard before. But with this loadout, I feel like it has a lot of breathing room now that the meta has kind of like flattened out. There's no real like this gun will beat this gun or that gun will beat that gun. Obviously, there are some outliers. The FAR is still gross even after a nerf. The Krig is still pretty good. The AK-47 is still pretty good. The Cold War version anyway. But we're going to get into this M4A1 build, starting with the Monolithic Suppressor. Just to stay nice and quiet and increase that damage range. So you get sound suppression, damage range. You do lose a little bit of ADSB and some A-walking steadiness, but, you know, it's really negligible. The stock M16 Grenadier, if you did want to mix this up, you could go with the Corvus Custom for a little bit of mobility sake. But this is the stock M16 Grenadier barrel is the one that hits the hardest. Commando foregrip, obviously, 60 round mags. And then I either swap between the Core Combat Hollow Sight, the VLK, or sometimes I'll even throw the GI Mini Reflex if I'm feeling a little bit of close range. I do have a video on my channel of me using the one with the GI Mini Reflex, and I absolutely shredded. So if you guys want to check that out, I'll leave a link to it down in the description, or you can click the card up in the top right-hand corner to take a look at that video. But with all that being said, this M4A1 build, man, it's nuts. As you guys can see in the gameplay in the background, it does pack a punch still. Even at range, it's still, you know, really, really good. I would say this gun is above viable as far as like what we're all using right now. I don't see any reason this gun would go away until they do the next weapon balancing update or anything like that. So the M4A1, it's here to stay. It's been here for a while. It's the easiest gun to use in my opinion. The MAC-10 obviously is pretty easy to use, but this gun in terms of usability, it's the easiest. Very minimal recoil. Quick reload speed, like the base reload speed is very fast. Even with the 60 round mags, it fucking fries. And if you guys want to check it out, I'll have some gameplay running in the background. We're going to talk about it a little bit, so get ready.